So you have a big email list of 100, 1,000, or thousands of emails, but you just don't know if they all work. Well, I highly recommend that you use a system to clean those emails to only use emails that work. Why? Because it will affect your email reputation. If you start sending out emails with an email list that you haven't verified, you're gonna get a lot of emails that bounce, and that will affect your email reputation. And then the next time that you send an email campaign, well, some of these might land on spam. So the idea is to clean the emails so you only send emails that actually work. This system that I'm talking about is called Bounceless, and it's really easy to use. You can verify emails one by one, you can upload a CSV with a bunch of emails, or you can automate the email verification each time that you receive an email using API. I'm going to show you this on my video. So let's go jump over to the deal and then the dashboard of Bounceless. So let's head on over there. Okay, this is the deal that's going on right now, and it's called Bounceless. It starts off at $59 for the lifetime deal, and I bet that most people will be fine with the $59 deal. Let me show you what that gets you. So this is the lifetime deal, and the $59 gets you 100,000 email verifications per month. I mean, that's a whole lot. Unless you're going crazy scraping emails, that's basically enough for most of us, even me. Okay, but if you need more email verifications per month, well, I recommend you jump into license tier 2, 3, or up to 5, which is 2 million email verifications per month. That's a lot. Okay, that's the deal that's going on. If you guys want to grab it, the link will be in the description. It's an affiliate link, helps me out with a small commission, and I'd be really grateful with you guys. So let's go and jump over to the Bounceless dashboard. I already uploaded a CSV with 757 emails. Well, guess what? Not all of those emails are good. So 92% of those emails were actually good. So 693 emails. 6% was invalid. So that's 39 emails. If I would have sent out an email campaign with that list, well, all of these emails, 39, wouldn't work. And accept all emails, our emails, our inboxes that are created to just receive all the emails. It doesn't matter if, for example, if I say johnny@yahoo.com, that's a real email. But if they created a random email to receive all of them, it could be like receiveall@yahoo.com, just an example. So that's accept all. Disposable emails are fake emails to create accounts. I've already uploaded a video talking about a deal that's called burner email. It lets you create emails to sign up for things, and then you just delete the email. And those are the disposable emails. Unknown, it's that the system couldn't verify it. And spam traps, so pretty basic spam traps, right? Zero of those emails were spam traps. So it cleaned it up. So now what I can do is go to download results, go for it. Hey, download results. Let me refresh. Oh, that's why, need to log in. Had it open for a while. Okay, so let me click on this list. There we go, download results. And now I have the option to download the results that I need. So for example, in this case, I only want to get the results for deliverable. I don't want results for invalid, for disposable, for accept all, unknown instead, or spam trap, okay? So I can download the CSV just for those. And the other way around, if I need the disposable emails, invalid, accept all, etc., etc., I can download CSV or XLS. So I have those options. And then that list, I'll upload it to my email marketing service, and then I can send out emails that I know are actually going to work, and it won't affect my email reputation, okay? Let's close this. Another way to verify emails is by one by one. So if I just add my email here, verify. There we go, valid. Okay, that's a really quick, easy way to verify an email. So we saw two of them. There's another way. So for example, we can upload from computer, which is uploading a CSV file. I can connect an integration. Let me show you the integrations that are available. So if you're using one of these integrations, then you're good to go. But what happens if I have an integration that's not here? I'm using another email marketing service, or I'm using something else. Well, that's where API comes in. This is the API, and you can generate an API for this. I created one for using with Pavli. And what it's gonna do is I'm gonna automate the process of verifying emails. So every single time that I get an email from any source, so let's just say I have a form that you have to fill up. Well, they fill it up. You receive that email, you send it through the API, and it verifies it automatically, okay? So several use cases. Let me show you my actual Tablet Connect. So this is my connection with API. You can use Zapier, you can use any other automation service that has API. This is just the example of Pavly. So if you have Pavly, this is how you would set it up, okay? With your API key, okay? So for example, I'm using the post method, the endpoint URL, it's this one, and this key is getting replaced by this label, okay? And the email, obviously, it's always going to be updated with the one that you're putting on this value. The idea of this is to automate the process. Let me show you what I'm talking about. In this case, I inputted a manual email. So I just put it there to show the use case. And this is my response for this. So email is disabled. But if this email was a good email, let's go ahead and save and test again. There we go, the value is okay. So the email is working. Now, what am I gonna do with it? Well, I'm going to automate this so this value gets updated from a source previous to this step, okay? In this case, I haven't set this up, but if this was a source before it, a webhook, another email capturing system, or capture emails from a group, or whatever, I'd use that source. And every single time, this is going to get updated and it's gonna add it automatically, just to give you an idea. Now, once we get this information, I would recommend that you add a filter. In this case, this is a filter, and I would say that if the API response is equal to okay, then we'll jump into the next step. If it's not okay, it won't jump to the next step. Now, what would I do with the next step? Well, there's several things that you could do with it. From here on out, I can send it to my email marketing campaign service, and each time that we get an email, it's gonna do the whole process. It's gonna verify it, it's gonna say if it's okay, we're gonna jump to the next process, send it to the email campaign, and from the email campaign, I would set up so it sends out that email automatically. So it sounds a little bit tricky, but it's actually not. I mean, it's gonna take you a couple of minutes or a few hours to set up the first automation if you're using API, but once you get it set up, you're good to go. I mean, you're ready and just let it flow, all right? So you have those options for Bounceless. One by one, upload, automation with the integrations that are available and the API. And you get the API summary of what's being used with that API. I can regenerate it, I can create new APIs if I like. Again, we just have to work with the limit that we have from the lifetime deal. We also have the statistics for this. On Bounceless, this is the overall statistics. In this case, I've just uploaded one, and this is the overall for the statistics, the pricing, the settings, documentation, if you need to view it. But basically, that is the Bounceless system to verify emails. Super important if you are planning to start email campaigns, or just to make sure that you have a good email list that actually works, and then start whatever you're gonna do with it. But that is the Bounceless deal. Like I said, it starts off at $59 for the lifetime deal. So you pay once, use forever, and it's gonna restart and refresh every single month with the plan that you purchase. So that's all you have to pay and you're good to go to start using it. Well, there you go, that's a deal. I thank y'all for watching. My name is George and this is SaaS Master. See you guys later.